Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back. Let's talk about safety issues with the niqab.
Ya bani Adam, qad anzalna alaykum libasan yuwari sawatikum wa risha wa libasu at-taqwa dhalika khayr dhalika min ayatillahi la'allahum yadhakkarun.
Now, a number of people, to my shock and surprise, have pointed out that niqab has some safety issues, and a number of sisters have expressed that they are not wearing the niqab even though they want to, because they believe that it is a risk to their safety. This seems to be a pretty popular response, and what I'm trying to understand is what logic is being used here, on what basis this is being said. Number one, hijab and niqab. Hijab is one of the most safe options for women. It is the safest option of clothing for women.
Ya ayyuha an-nabiy qul li azwajika wa banatika wa nisa'il mu'minina yudnina 'alayhinna min jalabibihin. ذلك أدنى أن يعرفن فلا يؤذين وكان الله غفورا رحيما.
If you want to compare the amount of people that are being abused wearing Western clothing, as we call it, or wearing immodest clothing, as we call it, compared to the amount of women that are being abused in modest clothing, in hijab, there's no comparison whatsoever. So this idea that somehow wearing just hijab and not niqab is more safe for a Muslim woman doesn't make any sense to me whatsoever. A couple of people have mentioned like being harassed or whatever for wearing the niqab. How do we know that those people who are harassing you wouldn't harass you just necessarily on the fact that you're wearing a hijab or you appear to be a Muslim person? Or if you weren't even wearing a scarf, just because you appear to be a person who's from another country, or because you're not white, or whatever the case may be. This idea that you can somehow change your clothing and it's gonna stop people from hating you makes no sense, because the people who hate you because of what you are, not because of what you're wearing. They hate you because you're a Muslim. So if a person sees you as a Muslim, they're not gonna like that. If you have a Muslim name, they're not gonna like that. If you look like you're an Arab, of Arab descent, they're not gonna like that. Just like it doesn't matter how light-skinned you are, if a person's racist against black people, they're not gonna like you. If a person wants to go and assault a Muslim person, they're not choosing to not assault the sister who's wearing a hijab or like a hijab back and you can see half of her hair and wearing a bunch of makeup, versus one who's looking like she just got off of the plane from Saudi Arabia. They don't care. They dislike Muslims. They are looking to abuse a Muslim person. So I even have an understanding for a person who says, I took off my hijab because I did not want to be seen as a Muslim person. I did not want to be recognized as a Muslim person because I was afraid that I would be abused for being a Muslim. But this idea that, you know, you could somehow wear a better hijab or a less hijab or a more colorful hijab and that's going to stop you from being assaulted makes no sense. And I don't understand why so many sisters accept this. I really don't understand why so many sisters accept this. Secondly, people stating that their spouse, their husband, is not supportive of them wearing the niqab for what one reason or another. Sister, I mean, you're already married now, you know, so there's nothing I can do about it now. I'm not a fan of, you know, telling people to break up their relationships, you know, and I'm not blaming your husband for anything. You know, maybe he's a perfectly good guy on deen. I don't know, but he could very well be a person with a disease in his heart. You know, he could very well be a marshmallow. He could just look like a man on the outside and be a marshmallow on the inside. I don't know what's wrong with these men nowadays that they don't want to support their wives, especially when it's their wife who wants to do it. If their wife wants to dress modestly and the husband is telling them not to because he's scared, what kind of a husband is it? What is his job other than to protect you? What is his job other than to teach you good things? What is his purpose then? This idea that somehow you're going to be more safe by looking less, you know, hardcore or whatever you want to call it is insane to me. You should actually look at the amount of women who are being abused daily. You can see the news every day out at the club scenes, you know, at the parties, in the parks where people are in the early in the morning, they're running around in little shorts. These people are getting raped and abused all of the time, assaulted, mugged, beat up, murdered, right? They're not wearing hijab, right? So we are more safe than they are in the hijab. It doesn't make any sense that you think that removing your clothing is gonna help you. And this is a trick of shaitan, by the way. Allah talks about it in the Quran.
Ya bani Adam, la yaftinannakum ash-shaytan kama akhraja abawaykum min al-jannah yanzi'u anhuma libasahuma lihuriyahuma sawatihima. إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ وَقَبِيلُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُمْ إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا الشَّيَاطِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ.
Shaitan, it wants to remove our clothing. He wants to do that. He's a pervert. He wants to get you to take off a little bit here, make it make sense to you to take off a little bit here, take off a little bit there, right? You don't see it, but it's clear. It's clear as day. There are people who are encouraging you and supporting you and taking off your clothing because they are predators. They are predators. That's what they are. And if you don't understand that, let me give you an example. Think of office clothing for women and office clothing for men. Men come in slacks, right? Loose pants, okay? Loose shirts, flat shoes where they could run if they needed to, right? The women are coming in a tight short skirt where you can't even run. You can't even lift your knees up, okay, to run anywhere. And pencil heels this long, you know? You're debilitating yourself is what you're doing. If your attacker comes to you, they're going out to the clubs like this, they're going out to the parties like this, you're completely debilitating yourself so that you can't even run away from a predator, all right? And they're supporting you doing this, of course, because you're easy. You're an easy target for them to get then, right?
قُلْ مَنْ حَرَّمَ زِينَةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي أَخْرَجَ لِعِبَادِهِ وَالطَّيِّبَاتِ مِنَ الرِّزْقِ قُلْ هِيَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا خَالِصَةً يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ كَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمٍ يَعْلَمُونَ.
So what if people don't like you because of the fact of what you're wearing, okay? They're not for you. They're not people to make your friends. They're not people to hang out with, spend time with. If you think like you're not being given some opportunity because of the way you look, do you really want an opportunity with people who hate you just based on the fact that you're a Muslim who don't even care like what you have to offer, what you bring to the table? The whole society is built nowadays, and we're supporting it, apparently. We're in support of it, but it's built so that brothers don't even have to. They're just lazy, lazy, lazy. They don't have to protect their sisters anymore. Brothers don't have to protect their sisters. Husbands don't have to protect their wives. Fathers don't have to protect their daughters anymore. We all agree, right, that man and woman are equal, right? Man and woman can do everything. They're interchangeable even. So let me ask you guys something, right? Let me ask you guys something. And what men do you know, Muslim or not, who's worrying about getting raped on the street or something like that? Men don't worry about these things. They don't worry about if someone's going to attack them at a party, if they're going to be drugged and raped, if they're going to be overtaken by some other man on the street and abused, right? These are things that women have to worry about. So why is it that you guys don't support each other in doing the things of the sunnah, like going in groups, going with your husband, telling your brother to come along with you? Why don't you guys do things like this instead of thinking with what logic, I don't know, that taking off some of your clothes is going to help you and keep you safe? That makes no sense whatsoever. And again, why would a husband or any man who's calling himself a Muslim suggest to his wife or his daughters that they need to take off their clothing in order to look less, you know, offensive? Makes no sense whatsoever. Anyway, I feel like we have a lot of excuses that we make And nowadays, we're banned from, you know, questioning anybody, right? We just have to understand where everybody's coming from and just, you know, like say, okay, sister, that makes sense. But when are we gonna start helping each other really and actually help each other grow and learn and say, maybe we shouldn't be following Shaitan. Maybe we shouldn't be listening to them or trying to appease Shaitan to leave us alone, because he's never gonna leave us alone. We might as well at least have our iman. You know what I'm saying? If we don't have anything else, we should at least have our iman and have some respect for ourselves. And we should be leaders and guiding and showing other people that there is another option to live life other than just doing whatever based on the fact that we don't want to be, you know, singled out in any way, right? Allah already singled you out to become a Muslim, right? It's a choice. It's a choice that you have to make. So just respect yourself, think about things, and ask yourself whenever you're making these kind of excuses, if would this be something that would be supported by the Quran and Sunnah? Think about those kinds of things. Don't just come up with excuses and expect that, you know, nobody's going to question you about that, because you might think I'm mean or I'm rude because I'm questioning you today. But remember, tomorrow or the day after that, Allahu Alam, Allah may question you about it. That's it, sisters. Assalamu alaikum. You guys have a wonderful day. Bye.